5 YouTube channel settings as a business owner that you need to know about on your YouTube channel if you're just getting started, or if you have a channel, you need to check that you've done these. Hi, my name's Anita Wong and I'm your host today, and I'm going to show you how to find these different settings that will make a massive difference to how your YouTube channel is seen and indexed by YouTube for your video success. So the first thing is, as you can see on the screen, that your channel needs to have a channel banner. So as you can see from my MidlifeTubers podcast channel, I have this wonderful banner along the top. This is like a billboard effect. Now, if you look on this channel, you can see that they don't have that top area. So when you land on their channel page, all you have is just their profile picture, but there's none of that sort of like billboard effect where you can actually see what's going on. This is really like your opportunity to advertise what your channel's about and also give that personal touch. As you can see on mine, I've got a little picture of me on there. So the first thing is that. Now, to find this, you can just go to your channel and click on this customized channel option. Once you've clicked that, just jump into the branding option. And as you can see there, they have this banner image area where you can just click change and upload the banner. Super tip for you, you can create the banner inside of Canva and they have some great pre-made templates. The second option for optimizing your YouTube channel as a business owner for success is to make sure that the about section is completely updated. As you can see from my MidlifeTubers podcast channel, the about section isn't very visible along here along the top, but it is here. You can see here I have this update here, and when I click on it, the about section pops up and it has a description of what the channel's about. It also has a link here and also a link here, and also to see the view email address, which means that people can reach out to you. It also has some information about the channel. Now, since YouTube removed the tab along the about section, most new YouTube business owners don't realize that there is an about section that you can actually use. So when you go to the customized channel area again, you just need to go to the basic info, scroll down, and that's where you can add in that description, and you can have up to 1,000 characters in that slot just there. Now, the third thing that most business owners don't do for their YouTube channel is to add a link. Now, as you can see, I have this bright blue link just here. Now, this automatically entices people to come towards and click it. Now, you can see also, if you don't have that link, then you won't have any way for somebody to contact you. Now, when I click on it, you can see that it opens up my about section and I've got two options. People can go and look at my other channel, which is my Anita Wong one, which you can see there, or they can actually book a call with me to discuss coming onto the podcast and featuring on here as well. So you can see how important these links are to business owners. If you have a product that you're selling, you'd want that link there to your shop. If you have a service that you're selling, you want people to book in and pay for maybe a power hour or a particular service, you want that link here. The most important link that you want people to click, if you only want one link on your channel, is this one here. So whatever you want the most important channel link to be, have that set as your top area. Now, the fourth option is actually going to save you so much time. And now this is the description default. Now, this enables you to have the same information show up on every video that you upload to your channel. Now, to find this, you do need to go into your YouTube studio. So you come to your homepage of your channel, click your icon and drop down to where it says YouTube studio. Go ahead and click that. Come to the left-hand side here where it says settings, click that, and then go to where it says upload default. So in this area, what you can do is you can add a description in here and any links that you want to show up every time somebody looks at one of your video descriptions. And this description will show up on every video that you upload. Now, that's a definite must, and it will save you so much time when you upload a video because you won't have to keep copying and pasting and repeating the same stuff over and over again. It's going to show up every time you upload a video. Now, the final area that I'd like to tell you about is actually the channel settings. So we're going to jump back into the dashboard, and it's exactly the same place as we went for the description, except we go to the general settings and we go to channel. So here you can state where your channel, where your residence is, but also these all important keywords that are related to the content of your channel. So these aren't specifically about a video on your channel. These keywords are related to the content that your channel is going to be about. So this is a must that you should be doing. And also in here, you can see that there is also this advanced setting area. So make sure that you have set your audience correctly so you don't have to keep doing that every time you upload an account. Also, if you have a Google Ads account, you can link that to it. And that's super important when you are doing any ads or whether you want any analytics and things like that. Also, just as a bonus, whilst you're in here, check the feature eligibility. Make sure that if you want the standard features that is enabled, go down to the intermediate features. As you can see, you have to fill this out if you want to put videos over 15 minutes, add custom thumbnails, and do live streaming. This is something that some of you may have stumbled across and not known what it does. This is super important. And of course, if you want to increase to daily video uploads and live streams, you need to check this area out as well. And it's just super easy to do. Just click on the sidebars and follow the instructions and you'll be all ready to roll. So I hope these five strategies to help you optimize your YouTube channel as a business owner, so that number one, people know how to contact you if they come across your videos. Number two, you have a call to action link, which will take people to one of the things that you are selling, whether that's a product or a service, or you want them on your email list, or you want them to maybe fill out a survey. Those all important links are super, super important for your business, especially if you want to make money from the visibility that your channel brings to you. My name's Anita Wong. I would love for you to hit that subscribe button. Do like this video. And if you have any questions about these features that I've just explained to you, drop them in the comments below. And if you would like me to do a video on something else to do with YouTube as a business owner, then drop that question in the comments as well. And I will try to oblige as soon as possible. Thanks for watching and I will see you in the next video.